Hello everyone, welcome back to the IS Network mains series, mains lecture series for internal security. This is the lecture 4 and today we'll be discussing the topic money laundering. So let's begin with the lecture. So in this lecture we'll first try and understand what is money laundering, what are the various mechanisms involved in laundering of money, what is the difference between black money, white money and laundered money. Similarly, we'll go through what are the various issues that are being created due to money laundering and how is it a threat to our internal security. Followed which, we'll understand that what are the various suggestions in order to tackle this menace of money laundering. So let's begin with the lecture. So first of all, let's try and understand what is money laundering. Money laundering is basically the mechanism of concealing or disguising the identity of illegally obtained proceeds in and trying to show that they are coming from a legitimate source. So for example, if money has been routed through, let's say, arms trade, illegal arms trade, and that money is somehow being routed through different mechanisms into the legitimate economic system so as to show that this money is coming from legitimate sources. So this is the basic meaning of money laundering. So the money coming from different activities could be routed towards this money laundering. For example, it might be coming from human trafficking, it might be coming from any other kind of activities, any other organized crime, or say drugs trade, etc., etc. So money laundering in itself is just the mechanism of hiding the real identity or the real source of money and disguising it in such a way that it appears that the money is coming from a legitimate source. So money laundering in itself is not a very big issue. However, this mechanism forms the basis for a numerous number of other crimes. So basically, it might be funding various terrorist activities, drug traffickers, corrupt politicians, leading to, say, change in the political regime in a country or destabilizing any economy, etc. So this is the various ways in which the laundered money could be used in order to create negative impacts or create issues for the internal security kind of a situation. So let's try and understand what is the difference between black money, white money and laundered money. So basically, black money in a common layman term is basically unaccounted money. So basically, the money for which you have not given the sources or the mechanism from where it is coming from to the tax officials. So basically, you cannot account for this money. So it is not coming from some legitimate, or it might be coming from some legitimate source as well as illegitimate source, but it has not been declared as to the tax authorities. So this might include your tax evaded money or the money coming from illegitimate sources. So basically, it might not always be linked to some kind of crime that is leading to accumulation of money. So it might include, let's say your salary is coming from your company and you are earning, let's say, 10 lakh rupees. But in order to evade tax, someone tries to fudge the numbers and show that you are only making 5 lakh rupees. So essentially, you are not paying tax on the remaining 5 lakh rupees, which is essentially black money. So black money legitimate sources se bhi aa sakta hai aur illegitimate sources se bhi aa sakta hai. Black money either could be aapne tax proper tax nahi pay kiya hai aur officials ko apni source of income proper tarike se nahi batai hai, jiski wajah se aapne tax evade kiya hai, wo black money ho sakta hai. Ya for example, kisi terrorist group ne arms ki sale karke wo proceeds kamaye hain. So black money could be legitimate as well as from illegitimate sources. White money is basically वो मनी जो हम आप एक नॉर्मल आदमी अपने पास जिसके पास होता है वो जिसके लिए अकाउंट करता है उसकी पूरी डिटेल्स देता है टू द गवर्नमेंट ऑफिशियल्स. सो व्हेन यू फाइल एन इनकम टैक्स ऑन योर इनकम, सो बेसिकली दैट इनकम दैट यू आर अर्निंग और द सैलरी यू आर गेटिंग फ्रॉम अ कंपनी और फ्रॉम एनी अदर सोर्स इज बेसिकली योर वाइट मनी. वेर एज लॉन्डर्ड मनी इज नथिंग बट द मनी विच वॉज नॉट coming from a legitimate source but has been showed to be coming from a legitimate source. सो फॉर एग्जांपल इसमें बहुत ही कॉमन एग्जांपल होता है हवाला चैनल। हवाला चैनल बहुत ही फ्रीक्वेंटली ऑपरेट होता है इन इंटरनेशनल लोकेशन। वहाँ पे बेसिकली इलेजिटिमेट मनी को विदाउट एक्चुअल मूवमेंट ऑफ मनी क्रॉस बॉर्डर सेटल किया जाता है। फॉर एग्जांपल अगर किसी आदमी को पाकिस्तान से इंडिया में हवाला के थ्रू कुछ अमाउंट भेजना है तो वो जनरली क्या होता है कि वो दो पैरेलल ट्रांजैक्शन से सेटल कर लिया जाता है। फॉर एग्जांपल अगर पाकिस्तान से किसी को 1 करोड़ रुपए इंडिया में भेजना है तो वो 1 करोड़ रुपए इन टर्म्स ऑफ करेंसी नहीं भेजा जाता, वो 1 करोड़ रुपए वहीं पे फॉर एग्जांपल किसी और पार्टी को इंडिया से पाकिस्तान को 1 करोड़ रुपए भेजना है तो ये दोनों ट्रांजैक्शन कैंसिल करके वो 1 करोड़ रुपए पाकिस्तान के एक एंटिटी से पाकिस्तान की ही दूसरी एंटिटी को भेज दिया जाता है। सिमिलरली यहाँ इंडिया में 1 करोड़ रुपए एक इंडियन एंटिटी से दूसरी इंडियन एंटिटी को भेज दिया जाता है। तो इस मैकेनिज्म के थ्रू बेसिकली वो पूरा सिस्टम हमारे इकोनॉमिक सिस्टम को इवेड करके उसके बाहर ही सेटलमेंट करके उस प्रोसेस को स्क्रूटनाइज होने से बचाया जाता है। सो दिस इज़ वन वे इन विच योर लॉन्डर्ड मनी इज बीइंग यूज्ड एंड बीइंग कंडक्टेड। तो ये एक बेसिक ओवरव्यू हुआ कि लॉन्डर्ड मनी क्या है, ब्लैक मनी क्या है, वाइट मनी क्या है और वो बेसिकली एक दूसरे से कैसे डिफरेंशिएटेड है। सो बेसिकली जो मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग का प्रोसेस है उसमें 3 स्टेप्स इन्वॉल्व हैं। वन इज़ नोन एज प्लेसमेंट, सेकेंड इज़ लेयरिंग, थर्ड इज़ इंटीग्रेशन। सो प्लेसमेंट इज़ नथिंग बट किसी तरीके से जो आपका डर्टी मनी है उसे आपको लेजिटिमेट सिस्टम में डालना है। फॉर एग्जाम्पल इसके अंदर क्या हो सकता है कि आपने 1 करोड़ रुपए फॉर एग्जाम्पल आपको जो आपका ब्लैक मनी था या डर्टी मनी था थ्रू सम इलीगल एक्टिविटीज़ उसे एक फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम में लेजिटिमेट सोर्स से दिखाना है। तो जनरली क्या किया जाता है कि उसे मल्टीपल सोर्सेज में डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर दिया जाता है कि फॉर एग्जाम्पल 15 बंदों को वो 1 करोड़ रुपए डिस्ट्रीब्यूट कर दिया जाएगा इन पार्ट्स एंड वो अपने अकाउंट्स में उसे सबमिट करेंगे। सो ये जनरली इसलिए किया जाता है क्योंकि एक बियॉन्ड अ सर्टेन अमाउंट इफ़ अ ट्रांजैक्शन इज मेड द बैंक्स आर ऑब्लाइज्ड टू रिपोर्ट इट टू द फाइनेंशियल इंटेलिजेंस यूनिट्स। सो बेसिकली अगर एक अमाउंट से ज़्यादा का ट्रांजैक्शन हो रहा है तो वो जनरली बैंक्स के द्वारा वो ट्रांजैक्शन फ्लैग की जाती हैं और उनकी स्क्रूटनी की जाती है। तो इससे बचने के लिए उस बड़े अमाउंट को स्प्लिट कर दिया जाता है मल्टीपल लेयर्स में और वो थ्रू डिफरेंट अकाउंट्स लेजिटिमेट फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम में एंटर किया जाता है। तो दिस प्रोसेस इज नोन एज प्लेसमेंट। लेयरिंग, लेयरिंग बेसिकली एक प्रोसेस है जिससे कि अब ये ट्रेस करना, ये जो डिफरेंट पार्ट्स में उसे एक बड़े अमाउंट को स्प्लिट किया गया है इसे ट्रेस करना मुश्किल बनाया जाएगा। सो बेसिकली अगर ए एंटिटी से बी एंटिटी तक पहुंचना था वो पैसा, वो ए से बी में ना पहुंचा कर ए टू सी जाएगा, सी से डी जाएगा, डी से ई जाएगा एंड देन वापस बी आएगा। सो बेसिकली ये एक सीरीज ऑफ ट्रांजैक्शन की जाती हैं सो एज टू कंसील कि उसका बेसिक सोर्स क्या था। एंड कोई ज़रूरी नहीं है वो सेम अमाउंट की ही ट्रांजैक्शन हो। फॉर एग्जांपल अगर एक ए अकाउंट में 15 लाख रुपीस डाले गए थे तो कोई ज़रूरी नहीं है ए टू सी में वो 15 लाख का ही अमाउंट ट्रांसफ़र किया जाएगा या सी टू डी फिर देन अगेन 15, वो किसी भी अमाउंट का हो सकता है। तो मल्टीपल नंबर ऑफ ट्रांजेक्शन्स के थ्रू वो बेसिकली अपनी ट्रेल कवर किया जाता है कि आप ये ट्रेस ना कर पाएँ कि वो सोर्स उस पैसे का कहाँ से है और वो सारे ट्रांजैक्शन बेसिकली रूट हो रहे हैं एक सिंगल ट्रांजैक्शन से जो 1 करोड़ मनी को स्प्लिट करके फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम में एंटर किया गया था। सो ये कंसीलिंग का जो प्रोसेस है वो है लेयरिंग। प्लेसमेंट वॉज स्प्लिटिंग द टोटल अमाउंट इनटू मल्टीपल ट्रांचेस एंड बेसिकली पुटिंग इट इनटू द फाइनेंशियल सिस्टम। लेयरिंग इज बेसिकली कंसीलिंग दैट अमाउंट थ्रू मल्टीपल ट्रांजेक्शन्स सो एज टू नॉट बी एबल सो दैट द सिस्टम इज नॉट बी एबल टू ट्रेस बैक द सोर्स ऑफ दोज ट्रांजेक्शन्स। सिमिलरली द लास्ट स्टेप इज इंटीग्रेशन। सो इंटीग्रेशन इज नथिंग बट सो इंटीग्रेशन में बेसिकली जो आपने इलेजिटिमेट मनी वहाँ उस सिस्टम के अंडर अब डाल दिया गया है उसे विड्रॉ करा जाना है फॉर सम अदर सम एक्टिविटी विच माइट इंक्लूड क्रिमिनल एक्टिविटीज़ और से पॉलिटिकल फंडिंग और एनी अदर काइंड ऑफ एक्टिविटी। सो बेसिकली इंटीग्रेशन इज बेसिकली विड्रॉइंग दैट मनी फ्रॉम द लेजिटिमेट सोर्स एंड यूजिंग इट फॉर द पर्पज विच इट वॉज इंटेंडेड फॉर। सो ये 3 प्रोसेस के थ्रू, फर्स्ट योर प्लेसमेंट, सेकेंड लेयरिंग एंड देन इंटीग्रेशन, इन तीनों के कॉम्बिनेशन से बेसिकली द मनी जो इलेजिटिमेट सोर्स से आपके पास आया था उसे लेजिटिमेट सोर्स दिखा के और अपनी इंटेंशंस को फुलफिल करने के लिए यूज़ किया जाता है। So this is the whole process of money laundering. So now we are clear with how, what is money laundering and how it is actually being done. Okay. So now let's try and look into what are the issues being created due to this money laundering. Why is it such a big issue that the people are being able to, let's say, show their illegitimate money as legitimate money and use for any purpose that they are intending to. So the issues with this is we will try to look at these issues from different stakeholders' point of view. So there might be some issues being created due to this money laundering for the government. Similarly, few issues might be created for the businesses. Similarly, our society also might be at a disadvantage due to this money laundering mechanism. So let's try and look it from the different stakeholders approach. So सबसे पहले तो let's हम पता करते हैं कि एक estimate देखते हैं कि money laundering का extent कितना है. So there no one actually knows what is the extent of laundered money in the global economy as well as the Indian national economy. However, there are different estimates by different agencies which says that according to IMF, there is roughly 2-5% of the GDP of the whole world. Approximately that amount of laundered money circulates in the system. So this is a very, very big amount. So the overall economy of the world is roughly $100 trillion. So out of that $100 trillion, 2-5%, which is roughly the economy of India in itself. So Indian economy is roughly $3 trillion. So it's more than the Indian whole economy itself. So you can estimate that what is the scale of these operations that are being going on, and if a terrorist group has that kind of funds which is equivalent to the GDP of a whole country, that too like India, it can create a lot of ruckus in the international scenario as well as create a lot of human rights issue and God knows what. So this is one indicator which shows that this problem is not a small issue, it is a very big issue. Then if we are to believe the different estimates of black money circulating in Indian economy, it could be anywhere from 20% to even 100% of our economy. No one knows the exact estimates. So these estimates are also given by various agencies, etc. So now we are knowing that yes, it is a big issue. Now let's try and look at what are the individual stakeholders have at stake when money laundering is affecting them. So let's try and look it from the perspective of government. So government is the biggest stakeholder which is having a lot at stake when it comes to money laundering. For example, if the government is not sure of what amount of money is there in the system, because money laundering ke through jo paisa aa raha hai wo accounted nahi hai, so and no one knows when and where it is going to be used. So basically when this kind of stuff happens, so basically the policy decisions of the government are at stake. बिकॉज हमारी जो मॉनिटरी पॉलिसी है वो बेसिकली कंट्रोल करती है कि इकॉनमी में कितना मनी सप्लाई है. सो अगर गवर्नमेंट को यही नहीं पता है कि एक्चुअल में अभी कितना मनी इन सर्कुलेशन है, तो वो मॉनिटरी पॉलिसी किस बेसिस पे बनाएगी. एंड जिस बेसिस पे वो बना रही है, इन केस द मनी सप्लाई इज़ मच हायर इन कंपेरिजन टू वॉट द गवर्नमेंट एंटिसिपेटेड, इट माइट एक्चुअली लीड इन टू अ सिचुएशन ऑफ वेरी हाई इन्फ्लेशन. सो दैट काइंड ऑफ सिनेरियो कुड हैपन. सिमिलरली कितना मनी किस टाइम पे ट्रांजैक्ट होगा किस करेंसी में, ये भी नोन नहीं होता है इन टर्म्स ऑफ मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग. सो मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग कुड बी टेकिंग प्लेस इन डिफरेंट करेंसीज. सो हो सकता है कि वो रूट किया जाए इंडिया में इन टर्म्स ऑफ डॉलर्स, इन टर्म्स ऑफ येन और एनी अदर करेंसी. सो इन दैट केस योर एक्सचेंज रेट गेट्स अफेक्टेड. सो अचानक से आपका एक्सचेंज रेट इफेक्ट हो सकता है, सो विच माइट लीड टू आर एक्सपोर्ट कॉम्पिटेंस और आर इम्पोर्ट बिल गेटिंग इम्पैक्टेड ऑल ऑफ अ सडन. तो हमारे जो आपके फॉरेन एक्स रिजर्व्स हैं वो अचानक से डिप्रिशिएट हो सकते हैं या इंक्रीज़ हो सकते हैं, या हमारे एक्सपोर्ट्स को बहुत जल्दी नुकसान हो सकता है. सो दीज काइंड ऑफ पॉलिसी डिसीजंस. सो अगर गवर्नमेंट ने एक पॉलिसी बनानी है फॉर एग्जांपल फॉर एक्सपोर्ट प्रमोशन या इम्पोर्ट सब्स्टिट्यूशन, एंड ऑल ऑफ अ सडन वी फाइंड दैट हमारी एक्सचेंज रेट गिर जाती है बहुत ज़्यादा, सो हमारा इम्पोर्ट बिल अचानक से बढ़ जाता है, विच माइट क्रिएट अदर काइंड ऑफ इशूज़. सो दीज काइंड ऑफ इशूज़ आर एनीवेज possible. Then there are other kind of issues which the government might face. For example, economic and political stability might be at risk, because agar money jo launder kiya ja raha hai wo agar kuch political interest ya ideologies ko further karne ke liye use kiya ja raha hai, which are trying to sabotage the development of the country. So it might actually lead into, let's say for example, it's being used for horse trading. So essentially hamari kai political established governments could fall in a matter of time if the money which is being used is laundered for creating political instability. And ye paisa jo money laundering ke through use ho raha hai, that might be used to fund, let's say, Naxal movements, insurgency movement. So it can create law and order kind of situation, as well as international crimes, which might include human trafficking, drug trafficking, or any other kind of organized crime. So usko control karne mein government ki ability ko hamper kiya ja sakta hai. So these all are the issues which the government can face. So be it political decisions, be it economic or political stability, be it law and order issues or international crimes. And when these kind of things happen over a period of time, it leads to degradation of the institutional trust that people have. So logo ka trust hamare institutions mein kam ho jata hai. And people might believe that whatever, so the negative consequences do not fall on the people who do negative things. So लोगों के अंदर जो मोरालिटी है, सोशल फैब्रिक है, वो डिग्रेड हो सकता है, बिकॉज पीपल हैव लेस फेथ इन द इकोनॉमिक सिस्टम. अब तो उस वजह से हमारा सोसाइटी है, ओवरऑल सोसाइटी को भी इम्पैक्ट हो सकता है. सो अगर हम सोसाइटी के लिए इम्पैक्ट्स देखें, तो इट माइट लीड टू द डिग्रेडेशन ऑफ द मॉरल एंड सोशल फैब्रिक ऑफ द सोसाइटी, वेयर पीपल थिंक कि नेगेटिव एक्टिविटीज़ और इलीगल एक्टिविटीज़ इज फाइन टू डू, बिकॉज पीपल हु आर डूइंग दीज काइंड ऑफ नेगेटिव एक्टिविटीज़ आर एबल टू go scot-free. Those kind of issues might also start prevailing, and these kind of money laundering could be used to propagate some kind of communal rights or some other kind of social inequalities, which might further lead to challenges to the integrity and the unity of our country. Similarly, agar hum businesses ke liye issues dekhen due to money laundering, so businesses ke liye bhi bahut zyada khatra hai money laundering ki wajah se. For example, अनड्यू कॉम्पिटिशन राइज कर सकता है ड्यू टू मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, कल तक किसी कंपनी का कोई मान लो दो तीन कॉम्पिटिटर्स थे, ऑल ऑफ अ सडन अगर एक नया कॉम्पिटिटर आता है और उसे मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग के थ्रू बहुत सारा पैसा मिल रहा है, सो ऑल ऑफ अ सडन दैट कैन डिसरप्ट द होल मार्केट, एंड बेसिकली जो बिजनेस की कॉम्पिटिटिव स्ट्रैटेजी थी वो कम्प्लीटली हेवायर जा सकती है. सो दीज आर बेसिकली, सो द कॉम्पिटिशन इन द मार्केट कुड बी ऑल टुगेदर ऑल्टर्ड इफ अ कंपनी इज गेटिंग मनी फ्रॉम illegitimate sources through money laundering. Then secondly, jo risk hai to the business goes up due to this money laundering, because policy uncertainty ho rahi hai due to money laundering. So the business risk also increases. Agar ek business ne international transactions kar rakhe hain, for example unhone kuch import karna hai, for example hamari petroleum refineries hain jo ki rock aur crude oil import karti hain foreign se. सो अगर अचानक से एक्सचेंज रेट्स बहुत ज़्यादा वेरी कर जाते हैं, सो बेसिकली देयर बिजनेस माइट ऑल्सो गेट अफेक्टेड, एंड द रिस्क, एक्सचेंज रेट रिस्क और द फाइनेंशियल रिस्क इंक्रीजेज मल्टीपल फोल्ड्स. सिमिलरली, जब बियॉन्ड अ पॉइंट मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग होगी, सो गवर्नमेंट्स रेगुलेशन माइट ऑल्सो इंक्रीज, विच माइट लीड टू डिक्रीज इन द ईज ऑफ डूइंग बिजनेस. सो विच माइट लीड टू समथिंग नोन एज रेगुलेटरी कोलेस्ट्रॉल, विच इज़ बेसिकली रेगुलेशंस लीडिंग टू इशूज़ फॉर द बिजनेसिस टू डू देयर business freely. So these are the various issues from different stakeholders' point of view that money laundering might be leading. So agar aapse question pucha jata hai, to try and structure your answer around these stakeholders, be it from the society point of view, be it from the government point of view, be it from the businesses point of view. So abhi tak humne samajh liya hai ki money laundering kya hai, money laundering kaise hota hai, aur uski wajah se kya issues create ho rahe hain. Now we'll try and look into few suggestions कि हम कैसे money laundering को tackle कर सकते हैं. अब ये चीज़ बहुत ही समझने की चीज़ है इसमें, कि money laundering एक local issue नहीं है, because आप नहीं जानते कि वो transactions कहाँ. पहली बात, इसमें multiple जो steps हैं that might be taking place at different locations. So जो आपकी placement हो रही है वो कहीं भी हो सकती है. For example, वो placement US में drug trade से हो रही है. Then your layering might be done through various different locations. For example, वो money SWIFT के through, EU के through route करके पाकिस्तान के through इंडिया आ रहा है, for example. Then your integration might be taking place in India to cause, let's say, some funding to the Naxalite movement. So in this mechanism you can see that different jurisdictions are involved. So this is not a local issue. कोई ज़रूरी नहीं है कि आपका प्लेसमेंट, योर लेयरिंग एंड योर इंटीग्रेशन इज टेकिंग प्लेस एट वन प्लेस. सो यहाँ पे बहुत ज़रूरी है कोऑर्डिनेशन बिटवीन डिफरेंट एंटिटीज एंड डिफरेंट ज्यूरिसडिक्शन एंड डिफरेंट गवर्नमेंट्स. सो बहुत ज़रूरी है कि इसके लिए मल्टी स्टेक होल्डर अप्रोच बनाई जाए, एज वेल एज वी हैव डिफरेंट गवर्नमेंट्स बीइंग इन्वॉल्व. सो जो हमारे सजेशंस होंगे वो भी हम स्टेक होल्डर्स के अकॉर्डिंगली सजेशंस देना चाहेंगे. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, सोसाइटी इस मैटर में क्या कर सकती है, बिजनेसेस क्या कर सकते हैं, गवर्नमेंट्स क्या कर सकते हैं, इंटरनेशनल एजेंसीज, कॉपरेटिव कॉपरेशंस क्या कर सकते हैं इस मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग के मैनेजर्स को डील करने के लिए. सो लेट्स ट्राई एंड लुक इट फ्रॉम द गवर्नमेंट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू. गवर्नमेंट नीड्स टू हैव अ स्ट्रिक्ट लेजिस्लेशन. वी हैव प्रिवेंशन ऑफ मनी लॉन्ड्रिंग एक्ट 2002. However, there are some loopholes as well as that law needs to be amended in order to take the current realities into consideration. So we need to have more stringent laws, stringent punishments, as well as we need to have our judicial system being proactive in this manner, and we need to dispose of the cases in a timely manner so that there is deterrence of law when it comes to money laundering. So legislation is one thing that the government can do. Secondly, the state needs to increase, reduce the pendency of cases, as well as the increase the certainty of punishment in terms of crimes when it comes to money laundering. Similarly, we can separate the proceeds from a crime versus implication of a crime. For example, if a government servant or some other person is having assets beyond his legitimate sources, the asset should be seized by the government and liquidated. Being able to prove that person as a culprit or not is a separate story. But if you can legitimately say that that person cannot justify the assets beyond his legitimate means, the asset should be seized by the government and used in some or other mechanism for social welfare. Similarly, the agencies needs to coordinate. So there are different agencies, be it CBI for investigation, be it CVC for investigation of public servants, or be it Enforcement Directorate. So all these agencies need to come together and basically fight this money laundering problem in a mission mode kind of a mechanism. Similarly, the government needs to form stricter KYC norms for various bank accounts so that no person can fudge the documents and get bank accounts and basically is able to layer or place that black money into the system. Similarly, there needs to be high political will in order to deal with this menace, because a lot of, as we all know, that one of the biggest source of black money as well as biggest placement of black money is into elections. So until unless there is political will, this problem cannot be solved properly. So political will is very, very important. Now let's try and look at what the international cooperation can do. So there is something known as Financial Action Task Force, which is an intergovernmental body which basically gives various guidelines in order to deal with this problem. It has given over 40 guidelines. So there needs to be a strict enforcement of these guidelines, and we need to name and shame as well as reduce any kind of dealing with those countries which are not engaging or not implementing the FATF guidelines. So there is something known as a blacklist, grey list of FATF. So Pakistan has been put into the grey list of FATF just because that it's not conforming to the money laundering guidelines put in by the FATF. Similarly, there needs to be active information sharing. There needs to be a coordination hub for information related to money laundering at the international level under the guidance of FATF, where proactively the information is shared between different countries. Similarly, there needs to be easy extradition processes between different countries so as to extradite the criminals from one location to another. We have the famous case of Vijay Mallya, who has been hiding in UK for a lot of time, and India is not being able to extradite Vijay Mallya from UK to India. So there needs to be easier extradition norms so that the criminals involved in these kind of processes are having a deterrence that they would be extradited from a country which they think that it is a safe haven for them to the countries where they have actually committed the crime and would be put behind the bars. Then there needs to be promotion of the Vienna and Basel Committee recommendations, which have given some recommendations targeting money laundering as well as drug trafficking. So at the international level, if we do these steps, there can be significant improvement in tackling with the problem of money laundering. Similarly, let's try and look at what businesses can do. Businesses have an important role in this problem because the money that is being used is routed through various shell companies, which are basically entities which do not have any legitimate purpose of being there. They are generally used only for these money laundering and other illegal kind of activities. So they do not have an active business processes involved. So the businesses could do the following steps. There needs to be a strong internal audit mechanism which tracks down what from where the sources of funding are coming from and where they are being utilized. So there needs to be a proper audit mechanism at regular intervals. Similarly, there needs to be proper regulation from the government point of view. So there needs to be proactive filing of returns as well as AI based scrutiny of those audit reports, as well as third party audits could be there. Similarly, the businesses needs to install a functioning as well as effective board of director body, as well as corporate governance mechanism, because this is the first instance where any kind of illegal activities or nefarious activities on the front of the businesses could be prevented. So this is one of the important steps. Similarly, there needs to be tech interventions as well as awareness among the employees about what is money laundering and how it is being done and how a person could evade being a part of it and being cognizant of how it is happening, and thus can even report in case some other person within the organization or within the system is doing it. So the businesses can take these steps. Similarly, what as a society can do? The society needs to boycott this practice of black money or a consumerism kind of culture which celebrates people having too much money. So if we as a society put up a strong voice against people who are getting money from illegitimate sources or who are laundering money from one place to another, then we can ensure that this problem is tackled to a great extent. We need to have high moral grounds that we would not be involved in any such kind of illegal or activities or money laundering activities for small gains, which might be monetary, which might be in terms of property, etc. So if we on our individual level and as on the society level are able to put up a strong stance against money laundering and against black money or illegitimate sources of money, then we can ensure that these kind of, because this is completely a demand and supply game, until we as a society should reject any political party which involves in these kind of affairs. So these are the various suggestions which could be put up in an answer for various stakeholders in order to tackle with this problem of money laundering. So in this lecture we try to look at four things. First of all, we try to look what is money laundering. We try to understand what is the definition of money laundering, followed with which we try to understand that what is the process through which money is laundered. Then we try to understand what are the issues with respect to various stakeholders arising due to money laundering. Then we found that what these stakeholders could actually do in order to tackle this problem of money laundering. So that's all from this lecture. We'll meet you in the next lecture. If you like the video, please subscribe to our channel as well as like and share the video with your friends. Thank you.